Joining me now, someone who knows a fair bit about borders and security, former Prime Minister Tony Abbott. Tony, welcome to the program. I know you've been following this issue of visas out of Gaza for many months now. Did Peta Dutton make the right call to demand an immediate halt to arrivals from Gaza, given the admissions from ASIO that they're only security checking those referred to them, not everyone coming out of the war zone?
And Peta, they can't really do proper security checks because ASIO is not on the ground, Australian officials are not on the ground. This idea that we are properly vetting people from Gaza, it's just impossible. And there's a world of difference between what's possible with people from Gaza now and what was done with people from the Syrian war zone back in my time as PM. But I do want to make this point, Peta.
Well, let me just, Tony.
As James Patterson said yesterday, the appropriate number of Hamas sympathisers in Australia is zero. It's zero. And anyone that we take from Gaza right now, you've got to assume, is a Hamas sympathiser.
Well, let's go to that point you mentioned there when you were Prime Minister in relation to Syria. In 2015, you took about 12,000 refugees from Syria. That's being used by Labor, by the Prime Minister in the Parliament today, as some sort of precedent for how the process should work with people coming out of Gaza. Have a listen.
Similarly in Syria, with the chaos that occurred, a special visa created for people from Syria, indeed. Order.
Now, it's not the same now as it was with you in relation to Syria, is it?
Completely correct. First of all, we specified that we were going to take persecuted minorities, and something like 90% of the people who came at that time were actually Christians from the Middle East. And second, we had our officials on the ground who went through and carefully vetted all of those arrivals. It is simply impossible to do security checks on people in Gaza who might subsequently come to Australia. So really, we are stuck with whoever chooses to apply. And you've got to assume, under current circumstances, that all of them are going to be Hamas sympathisers. We have enough Hamas sympathisers in this country already. We have too many Hamas sympathisers in this country already. It is a disgrace that we have had these massive protests almost from the very beginning, effectively in favour of Hamas. We've got rampant anti-Semitism. The last thing we need right now is to be importing more trouble from overseas. And I would simply remind everyone in this government, your first duty as a government is the safety of Australians. And this idea that you show compassion to the people of Gaza at the expense of the safety of the people of Australia, it's just wrong. And it shows that this government does not understand where its real duty lies. And you've made this point earlier on the show, Peta. If Egypt and Jordan and Saudi Arabia are taking zero Gazans because the last thing they want is to have more Islamists in their midst, why is it somehow our duty to take the people that their Muslim brothers, Muslim neighbours, won't take?
I mentioned immigration more broadly at the top of the show and made the point about statistics out today that says Labor's record migrant intake since they came to power is 62% greater than the Rudd-Gillard era, which was our last and highest benchmark. So that's a massive increase. Now, you're a migrant yourself. I'm the child of migrants many generations ago, but we are a very proud migrant country. But it's got to be in our national interest. And I guess the concern is if we're taking in volumes of people and we're not integrating them as we should, as we've done in many decades past, What's the risk to our values and our national character?
There are two problems with the current rate of migration, Peter. The first is that we simply can't house people coming in at the rate of 500,000 a year. And second, there's not nearly enough stress on the need for all our migrants to join Team Australia. And when you've got a government which is embarrassed about Australia Day, how can we expect migrants to take our country and its values as seriously as they should? And again, as was said earlier on the program tonight by one of your guests, we've just had a multicultural report commissioned by this government, presumably telling the government what it wants to hear. And this multicultural report says that we should have citizenship ceremonies in languages other than English. Now, come on. The absolute basic requirement of people who want to join Team Australia is that they strive to operate in the national language.
Tony Abbott, I know you love the flag, and I know you think English is important, so you're spot on. Thank you for joining me tonight. Thanks for your time.